Well, hi everyone. Thank you so much for tuning into this video. I'm Eric Thompson. I'm president of Windermere Real Estate Services here in Colorado. So this is just a quick little presentation that we put together called, just for fun, it's called The Sky is Falling. And this is a response to an article that ran over the weekend in the Denver Post all about real estate prices in Colorado in the Front Range specifically, and that also happened to talk about the Northern Front Range. This is a screenshot of that article. So because this has had so much reaction and because it's caused so many questions by our customers, we thought it would be good and we thought it would help people out if we just put this quick little video together to help answer the questions that are coming as a result of this article. So I'm guessing that a lot of people listening know me, but just real quick about my background in case you don't know me. I've been lucky enough to be in the real estate business here in Colorado since 1994. I actually grew up in real estate, so I've been around it my whole life. Spent my whole life here in Colorado. So I'm also known as someone who really studies the market. I do many presentations about the market, about both the Denver market, the Northern Colorado market, the Colorado market in general. I'm known as someone who spends several hours each week researching the market. I write our company's monthly newsletter. So I'm studying the market constantly, and someone who really understands the market and really understands the history of the market. And so I want to tap into that to help you out in case you do have questions about this article that really was saying that the sky is falling, right? So this article was citing a research firm who's thinking that prices across the Northern Front Range would fall by as much as 20% between the years 2019 and 2022. So let's dive in. Let's help you out with this. Let's answer the questions that you may have about this article. And because we've had some people have the reaction that they think that the sky is falling. So just for fun, we're calling this presentation The Sky is Falling. Okay, so first let's just have a little history here. So let's take a little walk down memory lane. Let's have a little history lesson. And a trusted source for us is the Federal Housing Finance Authority. We abbreviate that to FHFA. I encourage you to check out their website, FHFA.gov. FHFA tracks close to 300 markets all across the country, and they've been tracking these markets for many years, really for decades. And one reason we like this research is that it is an index. And what that means is they're not just tracking what's going on with average prices. They track actual sales of actual homes to come up with a really good idea, a real specific look at what's going on in each individual market. And they produce a quarterly report that we are sure to study each time it comes out. And we're always interested to see what's going on nationwide and also in our local market. So let's look history here. Let's first look at Denver using the FHFA data going all the way back there. You see all the way back to 1977 up until all the way through 2016. And so what you can see here is year-by-year appreciation. So those blue bars represent that particular year's appreciation. And the good news for the Denver market is that there are a whole lot of bars going up and not too many going down. So what you can see there, since 1997, 40 years, there have only been those handful of years where prices have gone down. So it looks like there are 7 years over the last 40 where prices actually went down. Otherwise, they were going up or they were kind of flat, right? So for example, let's just pick a year, the year 2000, the prices went up that year 13.68%. You should know the long-term average here over those 40 years is 6%. So that's the long-term average for the Denver market. And you can see what's been going on there recently is that prices have been growing more than the long-term average, close to double the long-term average. They've been growing in double digits. So a couple of important things to point out here. One is if we look here at the year 2008, which was arguably the worst economy of our lifetime, right here in 2008, worst economy of our lifetime, the Denver prices went down just a little bit over 2%, 2.24% is all they went down. And yes, there were a couple of years in a row where prices were going down, but certainly not on the order of 20% like this other data was suggesting. And then we see here recently, yes, prices have been going up more than the long-term average. But what that means for us, what we think is that over time, they will get closer to the long-term average. But history is not telling us that prices would go down by 20%. There's never been a time in history going back 40 years in the Denver market where prices have gone down anywhere near close to 20%. So as we think about this article, and the first place we go to is to think about history. History does not tell us that anything like that would occur. And if we now look at the Northern Colorado market, let's look at Fort Collins and Loveland, we see a similar trend. We see just a few years where prices actually went down. Again, the worst economy of our lifetime. 2008, prices went down by 2.2% is all. During the big financial crisis and meltdown, prices only went down 2.2%. So even with that, really, that cataclysmic event, prices only went down in the Northern Colorado market 2.2%. Long-term, these prices going back to 1978, long-term, the Fort Collins Loveland market, long-term average is 5%. Now, we won't take the time to look at Greeley, but what I can tell you is that it's a similar dynamic. Long-term prices average in Greeley 4%, and what we would see is a really similar dynamic for history. So that's the first thing we think about is, well, what's happened historically for prices as we think, well, prices may go down, gosh, 20%. Has that ever happened before? Well, no, not anywhere close to that. The next thing we would look at is population. It's pretty interesting. Even the Denver Post has cited, and this is an article from last year, that Denver and Colorado is a pretty fast-growing place in terms of population. So if we're going to have a strong housing market, we need to have people moving here, and that's been proven over time that people move to Colorado, right? I think we all know that just by judging on traffic, right? It can be a little painful at times. So what's happened for population over time? Gosh, since 1990, when we were a little bit over 3 million people, fast forward to today, we're now at about 5.5 million people on our way to 6 million people. There's never been a time in this history going back to 1990 where a significant amount of people have left the state. I mean, really, can you imagine a lot of people leaving Colorado? Why on earth would they do that? We have an amazing lifestyle, amazing weather, amazing recreational activities, and you know what? We also have amazing employment. So in order to have a healthy housing market, you also have to have healthy employment, right? You need to have people who have jobs, who are having great income so they can afford our housing. Look at this. This is going back to, again, in 1990. Unemployment rate, Colorado is the blue line, the United States is the red line, and what's been true over time is that Colorado outperforms the nation in terms of employment. Why is that? Well, it's because we have a diverse economy. We have great employers here, ranging all the way from, gosh, agriculture, we have the ski industry, we have healthcare, we have world-class universities, we have technology, we have all these different industries. We have oil and gas. We have all these different things that are contributing to our economy, contributing to our employment. So the good news for us here in Colorado in the Front Range specifically is that we are not relying on just one industry to make our economy go and then to make our housing go. So those are just a few thoughts we have about that article in the Denver Post. As we look at history, as we look at our crystal ball into the future, as we look at the fundamentals that are in place here in Colorado and the Front Range, specifically, that data, that research, what we know about our market is not telling us that prices would go down anywhere close to 20%. History is not telling us that. The fundamentals are not telling us that. You may have thoughts, questions, comments about this little video. We welcome those. We'd love to hear from you. You can see my email there. It's eric.thompson@windermere.com. If you want to reach out to any of the wonderful agents within our company all across Colorado, go to windermerecolorado.com. We have several offices across the Front Range to help you out. I really appreciate you tuning in to this little video. I hope this added some clarity. Hopefully this answered questions that you may have had after reading that article. Again, if you have other thoughts, questions, comments, please reach out. In the meantime, have a terrific day.